Om Tat Sat. My humble prostrations to the all-pervading Brahman or God, to my worshipful Guruji, Swami Jyotirmayananji Maharaj, to all the sages and saints of this world, and to each of you divine soul watching today's satsang. So today we will be studying Sutra number 30 from the Vibhutipad of the Raja Yoga Sutras of Patanjali Maharaj, commentary by my worshipful Guruji, Swami Jyotirmayanandaji, and narrated by myself, Swami Nikhilananda. So let's get started on Sutra number 30. Sutra is Kanthakupe Kshuta Pipasa Nivrittih. Again, Kanthakupe Kshuti Pipasa Nivrittih, which means by performing samyama on the pit of the throat, one acquires mastery over hunger and thirst. So a very practical siddhi or power that the yogi acquires. And whenever we use the word samyama, please remember it is the combination of all those three things: concentration, meditation, and samadhi. Concentration is thinking of an object, meditation is to focus on that object uninterrupted, which means no other thought wave should come and break that flow. And then meditation is the resulting benefit, the burning of the paper from a magnifying glass. When you focus the rays of the sun on the paper burns, but it doesn't burn automatically. You have to work for it. You have to take the magnifying glass. You have to make sure the focus of the sun's rays is intense on that piece of paper, and the reflection of the sun is directly on one spot, and then without any movement for a while, boom, the paper burns, isn't it? So I know when we were kids, we used to try to do that experiment. Well, samadhi is the same exact process. You just have to be able to let the mind be totally calm without other thoughts. So which means we should, therefore, yogis try not to be agitated too much. They maintain an even keel because they don't want these thought waves going up and down and thereby disturbing their peaceful vibrations. And once they have them, then they can focus on anything in a loving way, in a focused way, and then they are able to know the mystical qualities of that product. So in this case, by performing on the pit of their throat, they can acquire mastery over hunger and thirst. So this is extremely profound, especially since they meditate. Many yogis meditate for a long time and they don't want the frequent interruption of food breaks, water breaks, those kind of things, and they just want to keep on enjoying the practice. So they just focus that, and therefore the hunger is gone. And this throat is the seat of the Udana Vayu. And so there are different aspects, and we have covered those in previous videos. Those of you who are new to this satsang and to this channel, please subscribe and go through and watch so many deep mysteries and secrets of Vedanta that I have covered in other videos also. And one of the video is about the five pranas. In this case, that's what we are talking about: prana, apana, samana, vyana, udana. There are five different breaths, but udana is the prana energy, cosmic breath energy that resides in our throat. So this causes one to dream, and also at the time of death, this is the prana that becomes active and takes separates the body from the soul. And while we are sleeping, this is the prana that is responsible of calming our mind and senses and take them into the heart, and also generates dreams that we see. So this is responsible, and the same Udana Vayu is responsible for our hunger and thirst also. So therefore, when we control this Udana as a result of Samyama, which means focusing on that, the ability of thirst and hunger is significantly controlled, and it can be done at will. A yogi can fast for a very long time and yet maintain a higher level of vitality, and that's the key, that they're able to maintain their energy, their strength, even though they haven't eaten for a long time. Whereas most mortal people start to crumble down, they start to feel hungry, because the annamaya kosha, the body needs the food in order for it to sustain itself. But as we advance advance on this path, it becomes easier for a yogi to focus on this. So I hope this sutra, you enjoyed the sutra, and you're enjoying all the vibhutis, the glories that come through the blessings of intense samyama, which means intense meditation and mastery of meditation. So again, like we said, this is typically for advanced, these siddhis or powers come to advanced yogis who have been doing this for a very long time. But even if you are a beginner, you should take a lot of comfort in knowing that you are immediately starting to have a better impact on yourself. Your body will start to feel healthier, you will find more peace, you can concentrate better, and you will even see your performance at work increase significantly. So try to meditate for about 20 to 30 minutes at least every day, and it is much better when you do it after taking a shower. And if you have a dedicated place, a sanctified place that is holy, you can burn some incense, some light to bring you into that environment, and then just continue it. Don't do it one day and then forget about it for 2 months and then start again. That is not a good way. Just like you brush your teeth daily, just like you shower daily or eat your food every day, if you make it a daily practice, I can tell you, you will start to notice the difference. And then you can let me know. Please feel free to ask any questions if you have. I'll be happy to answer those. But I know many of you are already benefiting, and I feel very humbled and thankful that I have been a small instrument in your spiritual journey as well. This is Swami Nikhilananda. Om Tat Sat.